Hi friends, this is Varshita Subbarao along with Banu welcomes you to Green Coach online tutorial. In Green Coach today we will learn about the concepts of injury levels in integrated pest management. Yesterday also we had uploaded a part of IPM basic concepts. Today we will go in the subject in detail. We will learn about the concepts of injury level. Welcome to Green Coach. Integrated pest management. In the integrated pest management, we will learn about the concepts of injury levels. There are several concepts of injury levels. They are damage boundary, gain threshold, injury equivalent, EIL, ETL, EEL, GEP. Damage boundary, gain threshold, injury equivalent, EIL. EIL means economic injury level. Economic injury level. ETL means economic threshold level. ETL means economic threshold level. EEIL means environmental economic injury level. EEIL means environmental economic injury level. GEP means general equilibrium position. GEP means general equilibrium position. Let's learn about each and every concept in detail. The first concept is damage boundary. Damage boundary is nothing but the lowest level of damage where the damage can be measured. Means it is the starting of the damage, it is the initiation of the damage where we can found the damage and we can measure the damage. Damage boundary means it is the lowest level of damage where the damage can be measured. Damage boundary means it is the lowest level of damage where the damage can be measured. Next concept is gain threshold. What do you mean by gain threshold? It is nothing but the starting of economic damage. It is nothing but the starting of economic damage. Gain threshold is the term used to express the beginning of economic damage. Gain threshold is the term used to express the beginning of economic damage. It is expressed in kg per hectare. Gain threshold is expressed in kg per hectare. Next concept is injury equivalent. Injury equivalent. Injury equivalent is nothing but the loss caused by one individual insect throughout its lifetime. For example, if we took the caterpillar, it feeds on mulberry leaves, right? One caterpillar we consider means how many mulberry leaves it eats in its lifetime can be termed as injury equivalent. Means injury equivalent is the loss caused by one individual pest throughout its life cycle. Injury equivalent is the loss caused by one individual insect throughout its life cycle. Next concept is EIL, economic injury level. Next concept is economic injury level. Economic injury level is the lowest level of pest population density that will cause economic damage. Means for example, for a plant there are 20 thrips. If there are 5 thrips, it does not cause that much of damage. If it reaches 20 thrips per plant, it will cause the damage. These 20 thrips number can be termed as EIL, means the lowest level of pest population density that will cause the economic damage. EIL, it is the lowest level of pest population density that will cause economic damage. EIL means it is the lowest level of pest population density that will cause economic damage. Here the damage can be no longer tolerated. Here the damage can be no longer tolerated. Means at or before the EIL, we should initiate the control measures. Means at or before EIL, we should initiate the control measures. EIL means economic injury level. It is the lowest level of pest population density that will cause economic damage. Here the economic damage is no longer tolerated. Hence, at or before this level, control measures should be initiated. It is given by the formula EIL is directly proportional to C by VID. EIL is directly proportional to C by VID. That means EIL is equal to C by VID into K. EIL is equal to C by VID into K. Here EIL represents economic injury level. C means cost of management activity per unit of production. C means cost of management activity per unit of production. It is expressed in rupees per hectare. It is expressed in rupees per hectare. V is market value per unit product. It is expressed in rupees per kg. V is market value. I is crop injury per pest density. I is crop injury per pest density. D is damage per unit area. D is damage per unit area. K is proportionality constant. K here is proportionality constant. Next we will go for GEP. GEP is general equilibrium position. GEP is general equilibrium position, means it is the average population density of an insect over a long period of time, unaffected by temporary interventions of pest control. If we use some pest control measures also, some average population is present there in the field, no? The field cannot be pest free. Zero pest cannot be seen in any field practically. There should be some pest, so that the pest can develop resistance towards, so that the plant can develop resistance towards the particular pest, we should maintain certain level of pest. Even though we implement certain pest control, there will be some amount of pest. This average pest population can be termed as general equilibrium position or GEP. GEP is termed as, general equilibrium position is termed as, average population density of an insect over a long period of time, unaffected by temporary inventions of pest control. GEP is average population density of an insect over a long period of time, unaffected by temporary interventions of pest control. Next, we will see about ETL. ETL here is economic threshold level. ETL here is economic threshold level. It is the pest density at which control measures should be applied to prevent an increase in pest population from reaching EL. We already know what is EL. ETL means at this level, the level at which the pest should be prevented, means the pest should be controlled so that it cannot raise to EL level. ETL is the pest density at which control measures should be applied to prevent an increase in pest population from reaching EL. If we want to control the pest, and if we does not want to allow the pest to reach the EL, we should initiate some control activities in ETL. If we control the pest in ETL, it does not raise to EL. For vectors, ETL should be less than 1 or 0. It is very important bit. For vectors, ETL should be less than 1 or 0. In this graph, you can clearly understand about what is ETL and what is EL. If ETL is the position at which the control measure should be taken in order to suppress the pest to reach from EL. Here you can see the pest is at EL. If we use sprays, it is controlled to ETL. If we stop the spraying of pesticide, it will again rose to EL. If we control the pest, it will arise to ETL. Means at ETL, the pest should be controlled. At ETL, we should give the spray. Otherwise, it will rise to EL. After rising of pest to EL, if we spray the pesticide, it will again come to ETL. At ETL, if we apply pesticide, means it does not rise to EL. After rising to EL, if we use pesticide, means it will again suppress it to ETL level. Once you saw the graph, you can clearly understand. Next concept is EEIL. EEIL means Environment Economic Injury Level. EEIL means Environment Economic Injury Level. It is an Environment Economic Injury Level is an EIL. Means here we use the management tactics, but we cannot take only the direct benefits into consideration. We should also think about the environment. Means we cannot use the pesticides indiscriminately. Means we should consider the effects on environment. EEIL means it is an EIL that evaluates the management tactics based on not only its direct benefits to the user, but also its effect on environment. An EEIL is an EIL that evaluates the management tactics based on not only its direct benefits to the user, but also its effects on environment. Means we cannot think only of direct benefits. We should also think of environmental pollution. Hence, we cannot use the pesticides indiscriminately. Let's saw the summary of what we learned in today's Green Coach class. In integrated pest management, today we learned about the concept of injury levels. We learned what is damage boundary, what is gain threshold, and we learned what is injury equivalent, what is EIL, what is ETL, what is EEIL, what is GEP. EIL means economic injury level, ETE means economic threshold level, EIL means environmental economic injury level. So guys, that's all for now. Thanks for watching Green Couch videos. We'll update you soon with another video. Thank you guys. Please support us. Please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you. Thanks for your support. If you want to give us any suggestions, please comment in the comment section. Thank you. This is Varsha Subbarao along with Manu signing off for today. For further video updates, please subscribe to our channel. Share maximum. Thank you.